Morning, guys. Out in the boat again. We've got a bit of a breezy westerly this morning. It's a bit stronger than I was expecting, but anyway, we're here now. The whole idea today, guys, I've been given a few marks from a friend in close around off Cairns. So I've just decided to come out and check some of these marks, see what's on them. If I can find some fish, we'll have a fish. If not, we're just going to see if any, wonky. Some of these are wonky holes, some of these are wrecks, some are just, just marks, just reef. So I'm just going to go for a bit of a play around, have a look at some reefs, see if we can find any fish on them, or see if we can actually find the reefs or the marks. And go from there. If we can find some fish, we'll put some baits down and see what's on them. Anyway, I just thought I'd do a bit of quick filming, guys, because I just saw the sunrise. Looking around some marks this morning and haven't found bugger all. So the marks have been empty, not much on the bottom, no bait, no fish. So I've just been looking around. I come across this lump, middle of nowhere, and it seems to be covered in bait. So that's what I'm doing now, putting down a bait jig to see if I can get some bait. If I can get some bait on this thing, I'm just going to stay here and put the bait back down and see if there's any predators around. I'm only in like 32 metres or 31 metres or something, not very deep. So let's see what happens here, eh? Just coming up, up onto the edge of it now. So I'm assuming the bait jigs up here will work the same as down south. You never know. Don't even know what sort of bait it is. Sure what I've got, guys. I don't even know what it is. There's something very small on there. Maybe I've got some pilchards, who knows. I can't go in there. First bait off Cairns. The size of that monster. Pretty huge. But he'll do it, he's a snack. It's nice to know there's some yakkers down there though, that's good. If I can get a few of them, I'll be quite happy drifting around here with some yakkers down, that'd be very good. You'll soon know if there's predators around. All right, guys, I'm having a bit of trouble getting bait. Hooking the bait, all good. Plenty of bait at the bottom, all good. Getting them up, no good. I don't know what's down here, but I just can't seem to get the bait through them. Every time I hook a bait, it takes off. I've lost a couple of hooks. I'm guessing they're probably mackerel, because they take off really quickly. Give me a little bait jig. So, and the silly thing is, today I only bought a couple of bottom bashing rods and some bait. I didn't bring any lures whatsoever, no jigs. And this would be a perfect spot for jigs. Apparently there's mackerel or something down there eating the bait, so this would be a good spot for micro jigging. But I didn't bring any of that. At least I marked it, so hopefully bait's here another day and we'll come back and give it a crack. Coming on to it now, guys, so let's see what happens this guy. I'm starting to realise when people don't bait jig up here too much, you can't get the bait up. It's thick as in the sound. I should have all six hooks, or whatever's left, five hooks, four hooks, loaded, but now they're not eating. Whatever's down there is bugging them. They're not eating now. I've got some cuttlefish there. That's all I bought. No pilchers, nothing. So, I thought I had pillies in the freezer, but no. So I've got some cuttlefish. I might just put that in a paternoster and put it down there and see what happens. Might get lucky. Might be a redfish or two on amongst all this. Sound is actually chockers, like 30, 25, 5 metres, 6 metres, 7 metres thick of bait. And red, thick bait. And I can't even get a touch now. Whatever's down there is just annoying the bait. Oh, guys, I might go for another drift. I'm just going to put a paternoster down. That's reef. I just lost my sinker. Oh guys, beautiful day now. I was on my little wrecking there, catching a bit of bait, and these other guys come out in their little black boat, and they were watching me. And they just got closer and closer and closer. And while I was drifting, and once I drifted off the bait, they turned around, went in and spotlighted on it. Just locked me straight out of the spot. I thought that's bloody, that's marvellous. So instead of putting up with that BS and stuff, I've had a look at the sound and I saw this little lump a few k's outside of Green Island. So I've come out here and noticed this, found this little bump. It goes from 40 metres up to 18. Middle of nowhere, I'm outside the green zone, everything else, which is good. Found this, but looked like bait, so I dropped bait jig down, got a couple of those small little yakkers again. I thought, okay, they're only small up here, but that'd be all right, bait. I just got to change the hooks. So I went back down for another drift and took this critter. I'm guessing a full string because I had what felt like quite a lot. Next bit, it freaking took off. As you heard, Rod was screaming. And now I've got something on this is a bait jig, by the way. I've got something on this bait jig. I'm guessing he's tangled up in it. I don't know what it is. I think he went in to eat the bait, got tangled up in it. And now, I wonder a really, I don't know, a good fish or a shark, or I don't know what it is. On your little bait jig rod, on your bait jig. I would like to see it. Took off at a great rate of knots, now it's not doing much at all. I think it's got tail wrapped. But I can't put a lot of weight on it because it is, bait jig. It doesn't want to come up to the boat, that is for sure. Sounds a bit cranky, doesn't it? But it's fun. I was hoping to try and find a couple of redfish out today around one of the bumps or something in close, but I don't think that's going to happen. But after I get this or lose this or whatever happens here, I'm just going to go fish these bumps I got here. I don't know what this is. Fish these bumps around here and we'll see what happens, eh?
Okay, I thought I was getting a bit closer, but it's just jellyfish in the water. Whatever this thing is, it is coming. It's definitely got to be tail wrapped. Oh, damn, guys, after what, about 10 minutes on a bait jig, it just popped. Ugh. I don't know what that was, I would have liked to have seen it. Would have loved to have seen it. I'm missing one hook, that's it. Missing one hook. Bugger. Finally, I come in close and there's another wreck. This is, must be a mackerel. Ooh, and there's a big cove. There's a cove trying to eat me mackerel. Check this stuff out, guys. That's a cobia trying to eat me. Trying to eat me spotty. Oh, that's a decent cobe. Oh, oh, he's got it. He's got it. Look at that. Look at that. That was some pretty awesome footage. Anyway. Hey, Mr. Cobia. A little schoolie. And there he goes, a cobe's after him, straight down. Which is pretty cool. Well, like I was saying, I'll just come into a closer. There's a mark. I've never been here. And I actually found the wreck and it's covered in bait, but I can't get bait. You just can't get the bait up, it keeps on getting pinched, and the cobia might be the reason. And that little mackerel. So
finally hooked something small on this wreck. It's been a little quiet since we threw the mackerel back and probably let the cobia eat it. What do we got? My first red fish in the boat. Pretty little thing, but not what we're after. Pretty little fella, but anyway, goodbyes. Not what we're after, guys. I'm sort of hoping I'll hook that cobia just for a bit of fun, just for a fight, and then I'll let it go. It wasn't a monster, but, you know, probably a 30 pound, I'd reckon, maybe. 25 maybe, 25 pound, somewhere around there. But still, would have been a fun little fight. Anyway, we'll keep going here and see what else we can hook.
For our last little tiny baby yucca. Then after this, guys, I think I might just head home. I think about seriously what to do with this boat, and it's just a bit small. It's just a bit small for what I want to do, but I'll give it one crack. I think we might go buy a bigger fuel tank, or an extra fuel tank, and wait for a nice weekend. I might actually go out wide and stay out wide and come home the next day. Oh, that's a pricey one. That's better. Oh, nice. Yep, we'll go out wider. This time, yeah, go do a bit of camping out water. Ooh, another one of those things. Pretty little things. Goodbye. He's gone. Maybe you put down a squid, see what happens. Just off to the side of the main channel. The tourists over there stepping on the top deck trying to wave up at the front. Whoops. Don't make any noise, it's all good. Alright. This might be the last one. I'm hoping I got the cobia on that camera trying to eat the mackerel. That was pretty cool. It's not too bad of a day. But yes, I think might have to get some extra fuel, guys. Run out to one of the wider reefs and sleep on it for the night. Do a bit of fishing out wide. Aggressive little buggers down here. Didn't take long to clean up though. Cuttlefish. Damn, they're fast. Might be the last one. I think it's the last one. I'm gonna get out of here. Gotta go to work tonight anyway. Yep, I think, guys, buy an extra 20 liters of fuel. And seriously think about going a bit wider. Look on the maps and charts, see where I can go and spend a night. Spend a night out wide. Do a bit of fishing out there. Not finding a lot in these close reefs, like nice cobia, a few small mackerel, mixed reef fish, but nothing exciting. I'm sure there's some good fish in here. I'm just going to need more than a couple of trips to find them. It's going to take a while, but we need to go out a bit wider and catch some decent fish in between the search, and just, you know, keep it interesting. Oh, I'll probably clean this one up too. Yeah, good. Ooh. Okay, that's a bit bigger. nice fish. Oh, better not be a shark. There's the leader. What do we got? Oh, well, had to. Yep. Nice, nice trevally. Nice little trevally, guys. For sport fishing and stuff, this is fun. But if you want to go get something deep, I think we're going to have to go a little bit wider. Or up on the shallows. Try and find some trout. But that's fun. But also gone. Got me around the other one too, bugger. Oh, we've got one more bait. Why not? Lucky last one. Might as well you can work out a way to catch as few livies out here. I mean, get them to the boat and put live baits down around these wrecks and shallow reefs. You probably do all right. A few sharks, but maybe some good quality fish to eat the livies. I've been through two bait jigs this morning and caught three tiny bait. Only got three, managed three tiny ones to the boat. Everyone else got eaten. Had a good battle out wide for a while on the bait rod. That was a really good fish. And you end up popping the bait jiggers. It's very wet in Cairns. Looks a bit wet where I'm going too. Well, this is all apparently from over in the Gulf where a cyclone's brewing or something. All this weather's blowing in from over there, so. Anyway, might be a wet couple of days. Need some time to clean up the boat and get another fuel, an extra fuel can. Check the weather, look at some charts and see where I'm going to go. Go for a mission. I've been cleaned up already, guys. Okay, on that note, I'm going to say see you all later. See you in the next trip. Thanks for watching. And yep, see you soon.